हेलो एवरीवन, यू आर ऑल वेलकम टू लेक्चर नंबर 910 एंड टुडेज टॉपिक इज एनामेल्स ग्लॉस फिनिशर। एनामेल्स आर एक्चुअली आल्सो अ टाइप ऑफ वार्निश, बट वंस पिगमेंट इज एडेड इन द वार्निश इट इज कॉल्ड एनामेल। सो वी कैन से दैट एनामेल्स आर pigmented varnish where different color of pigments are added, and enamels they are having luster, very good shining and quality is good, and gloss means actually luster, that's why it is known as gloss finisher. And here the ratio, or we call a percentage of the pigments, are very important, and the percentage of pigment should not go more than 25 to 40%. Actually, ideally it should be between 25 to 30, because there are some pigments, their intensity is very high, like black color pigment. So black color even 2% is enough, and for white enamel, the most popular or important pigment is known as titanium dioxide or composite titanium dioxide or calcium sulfate. And here, to prepare the enamels, we have two methods. One, we are using oleaginous substance where the resin is mixed with vegetable oil like tung oil or like rushseed oil, some other castor oil like that, and then we are adding the required amount of pigments. The other method is where we are not using the oil, we are directly using either synthetic resins or natural resins and solvent directly, and there has to be good selection of solvents because it must dry quickly. So we have to select such type of solvents which can dry quickly, and in order to accelerate the drying process, we are adding drying agents, some metallic like cobalt, like zinc, manganese, they are added. So the manufacture of enamels or gloss finishers, number one point, pigmented varnishes are usually known as enamels, and the purpose of manufacturing of enamels is to get a good gloss. Gloss means luster, shining, because after drying the enamels form a very good lustrous and glossy finish. That is the role of enamel. And when we are talking of varnishes, varnishes are without pigment, unpigmented, so that will not be having very shining color luster, or it will not give glossy finishing. So that's why enamel is considered as very good quality varnishes with pigments. Number two, the pigments vehicles, dryers, thinners are the various ingredients used in the manufacture of enamels. For example, titanium dioxide or composite titanium dioxide or calcium sulfate is used in the white enamel. Enamels are having generally pigment volume concentration, and apart from white, if you are interested in green, blue, yellow, so those pigments are added. And these pigments which are added in the manufacture of enamels is having in volume concentration, that is pigment volume concentration, PVC. and that PVC should not exceed more than 25 to 28%, and at any cost it should not go above 40%. So the enamels are having generally pigment volume concentration at the PVC between 25 to 28%, but it never goes above 40%. And number three, vehicles, drying irons, that is known as vehicles here, to be used in enamels is either oleoresinous vehicles. Oleoresinous vehicles means where resin is added in linseed oil, tung oil, or any suitable vegetable oil like soybean oil. Oil plus resin or only resin, two possibilities are there. Oleoresins, a vehicle is prepared by cooking together one or more resins such as ester gums, phenolic resin, lime rosin, etc. With one or more drying oils such as linseed oil, tung oil, soybean oil, and dehydrated castor oil. Number four, when natural or synthetic resins are used alone, the resins are dissolved in suitable solvent. And when I am saying suitable solvent, means you have to see the quality of that solvent, its drying capacity, how easily it can be dried, its viscosity, lot of factors you have to consider. And solvent and to this solution to other ingredients are added. Drying of the oil can be accelerated by the addition of certain metal accelerators such as cobalt, zinc, manganese, calcium naphthenate, and that is oleates. So naphthenates and oleates, they are added to accelerate the drying property. So number five is, here I have given what type of mills we are using. There are two type of mills, one is called pebble mills and another one is called rural mills. They are used to make the enamel. And here the pebble mills means they are made up of ceramic with lining. So there it is used to make it fine. Paste in the form of powder also, and in roller mill they are using the rollers, and with that roller it is fine paste is produced. And here I have given in two chart, one that is oleoresinous enamel, their constituents percentage, that is PVC, and the second one where only synthetic or natural resins are used in solvents. So number five, the enamel can be manufactured either in pebble mill or in a rural mill. In pebble mill, all the ingredients are charged in specific quantities with sufficient grinding time to get high gloss enamel. And the second one is that in rural mills are used with paste mixtures in which pigments and vehicle are mixed together to form a paste. Here I have given the example of oleoresinous enamel, the one where the resin is mixed with linseed oil or any suitable vegetable oil. So here ingredients and here the quantity in gallon is given. And you can prepare the enamel by adding these percentages. So one is that is pigment is your titanium dioxide. It should be 18.55 gallon. Number two, heat body linseed means heated. It should be 25 gallon. Number three, fine calcium carbonate powder. It should be 5.45 gallon. Number four, ester gum solution. Ester gum solution, it should be in spirit or any suitable solvent. It should be 37.60 gallon. And cobalt naphthenate should be 0.25 gallon. Then six is, that is lead naphthenate. Lead naphthenate should be 0.40 gallon. And number seven is mineral spirits should be 12.75 gallons. And if you add all, it will be the total quantity will be 100 gallons. And here note down the pigment volume concentration, that is called PVC, of this composition is maintained 33.3%, because at any cost it should not exceed more than 25 to 35%. The second one is the example of resin enamel, where that is oils are not used. Here suitable solvents are used. So ingredients and quantity. That titanium dioxide is 8.6 gallon. Number two, zinc oxide, that is fine particles, very fine powder, is 0.5 gallon. Number three, alkyd, that is also known as long oil, is a type of resin, and that is polyester or thermoplastic type, that is called long oil. It should be 62 gallon. Number four, mineral spirit should be 28 gallon. Cobalt naphthenate, where cobalt content should be 60%, should be 0.4 gallon. Then lead naphthenate, where the lead percentage should be 24, it should be 0.3 gallon. And number seven is calcium naphthenate, where the calcium percentage should be 4, it should be 0.2 gallon, and in total it is 100 gallon. Note, the pigment volume concentration, PVC, in this composition, what you are preparing, will not exceed more than 27%. So with this I will stop. Thank you very much for watching the lecture.